Hello everyone, welcome to the grade and textbook tracker spreadsheet demo. In this demo, I'm going to show you how to use this grade tracker and how to get the best out of it. So here we're starting with the instructions page. Here you can find useful links. In addition to that, there is a step-by-step tutorial and FAQ section. This is a good place to get an overview of the spreadsheet and how it works. So moving on to the next tab, this is the setup tab. This is where you would add your courses, your grades, your grade points based on how it's used in your university and your semester terms. The first column is where you would add your courses. With this column, you want to ignore the first cell because this is part of how the formulas work. So don't delete the cell, just add your courses underneath this section. There are some courses already added. Go ahead and delete them and add yours. To add a course, double-click on the cell and type in your courses. The setup tab will also come with the different grades. This is a commonly used grade system in the United States. However, you can delete them and add your own, similar to how we did here. Just go ahead and delete and type in whatever grading system works for you. In addition to that, you can type the grade points, and this will help you automatically calculate your GPA for the semester for your entire program. Here is what you add your semester and terms. It comes pre-populated with fall, spring, summer, and winter. Just like we did before, delete them and add what applies to you. Moving on to the grade tracker tab, this is where you add all your courses. The first section will help you view your GPA based on the semester and the year you select, as well as your overall GPA. Here would be a graph that would help you visualize your GPA trends over the different semesters. And the table below is where you would add your actual courses. Let's go ahead and add some courses to see how it works. So first you select your semester and your year. Add the course ID based on the ones we added in the setup tab. We'll add the course name. We'll add our credits. Here you can add your expected grade. This will not affect your GPA calculation. This is just to help you plan your courses before your final grades come in. So here we'll give ourselves an A minus. And as you can see, the grade points calculate, and this is how the GPA is calculated using this grade point system. If we go over here, you see that nothing shows up, and that's because the semester information does not reflect what is down here. So let's go ahead and change that to fall of 2023. As you can see here, it adjusts to reflect what we've added. So let's go ahead and add a few more. Here I've added 4 entries, which represents fall 2023 and spring 2024. And as you can see here, we do have a graph that represents the overall GPA for fall 2023 and the overall GPA for spring 2024. If we go to this table, it reflects the fall 2023 data. As you can see, we have 6 credits that we have enrolled in for the fall. So that's 2 credits and 4 credits here. And we have 2 courses, which are the 2 courses we entered here. And the A for the semester is 3.4. The overall GPA though is 3.55, and that is because it's taken into account spring tour data. So if we were to change this to spring of 20, you can see now that it actually changes the credit hours to match the spring, which is also 4 and 2. So if I were to change this to 3, for example, you can see the total credit hours would be 5. And again, we do have the number of courses as 2, and the GPA as 3.6, and the overall GPA as 3.51. So that way you can add up all your courses and you can see the trend of your GPA as you take the different courses throughout your study. The last part of this template would be the filter option. So if you wanted to filter based on the year or the final grade, so let's say you only wanted to see entries for 2023, you can go ahead and remove blanks as well as 2024 and hit OK. If you do see this, just go ahead and click on OK. It just means there's something that you're not supposed to be changing, but this should be OK because you're only using the filter system. So go ahead and say, don't show this for 5 minutes. As long as you're only trying to filter, it shouldn't be a problem. And as you can see, you're able to view the information only for the fall 2023 information. Doesn't change anything up here. This is just to declutter the table, just in case you have a lot of information added to the table. All right, we'll go ahead and show everything. And we can also filter by final grade. So let's say you wanted to see all the courses that you have a certain grade mark for, you can go ahead and select the one you wanted to see and hit OK, and it should filter out the grade that you selected. All right, the next tab is the textbook and resources tab. It's very straightforward. This is where you would track all of the textbooks and all of the resources that is required of you to complete your course or your study. So we'll start here with selecting your currency. Delete the currency that's there by double-clicking and adding in your own currency. So for this one, it was the dollar and I changed it to the pound. And as you can see here in the price, it changed the currency to the pound. So all you need to do is just type in your currency symbol that applies to your country and it automatically changes here as well as in the column where the price is displayed. The next area is a filter. This is where you see the entire amount of money you spend for textbooks and resources. Here you can filter by semester and year. And here, just like the total amount of money spent, this shows you the total amount of books you have purchased overall. And here you can see your top four most expensive books. And just like we had before, we have an area that would allow you filter. And this is an area that would allow you highlight a course based on an entire list that you have here. I deleted the entries we had before to show you what it would look like to add one from scratch. So the first would be to select the course and the semester, the year, and the date that the textbook is due or the resource is due. Type in the name of the book, the source that you intend on getting the book from. So let's say I'm going to buy it from Amazon. The dates that you purchased it, how much you spent on the book, the status. So if you ordered it already and if you have received it, if you're going to borrow it, whatever the status is, go ahead and select that and add in whatever notes that you need to add. Go ahead and add another one. Now that we've added two textbooks, you can see it shows the total amount of money that we have spent so far and the total number of books we've purchased. And of course, it shows us the top four most expensive books because we only have two. It shows us the two books that we have purchased. Right, so to show you how the filter works, it's just like the other filter. In the grade tracker tab, go ahead and select the semester and the year. So here it already selects fall of 2023. So if I already change this to spring, you see that all these values change to zero. Going back to fall, you can see that we have purchased two books that cost, and the most expensive is 60 and the least expensive is 50. And the final area would be the filter where you can filter by DON, source, or status. But the last thing I wanted to show you is how you can use this DON filter and this DON checkbox. After you have completed everything for this textbook, you can check it off. You can leave it as is or you can check it off just to cross it off your list as completed. So you can change it to receive and you can cross it off. You can leave it on if you want, but that way if you wanted to just keep track of what's active, you can go ahead and cross it off. Now, if you wanted to use this for another semester, for example, and you wanted to clear out the page because you didn't want to see anything related to the fall semester, you can use this DON filter to get rid of what you're no longer using. So let's say this is for the spring semester and you wanted to get rid of the fall semester books and resources. Go ahead and click on this filter. And click on true. True means the checkbox is checked. And false means it is not checked off. You want to see the courses that have not been completed, so make sure false is checked and click on OK. That way, if you have a long list of courses for different semesters and you wanted to only focus on the courses that you were currently working on, you can use this filter. Do note that it does not change any of the amounts here, so you would still have the fall 2023 totals here as well as the total number of books and the more expensive books. This is just to help you visualize the bottom area and to make it clutter-free just should you have a lot of entries in this section. All right, so that is the end of this walkthrough video. If you have any questions, go ahead and send me an email. I have my resource page here that you can find my website as well as my contact information and my email address. If you need to contact me, thank you so much for watching.